The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 6th chapter, text number 40 through 43, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in September of 1966 in New York.
Kasvidyate nahi kalyana kasi dugyati tapagacchati. Now this verse we have been discussing last day, that one who falls down, suppose one has entered for spiritual cultivation of life, somewhere or other he is not successful to complete the course, then what happens to him? Oh, that was the question of our Gita. This is a very nice question. suppose one enters for cultivation of the spiritual life, somewhere or other, sometimes we do not follow the rules, sometimes we are entrapped by some feminine attraction. These are impediments. So we may not be able to make complete progress. So Krishna says, my dear Krishna, Arjuna, nahi kalyana kit kachit durgati. Anyone who has attempted even 1% sincerely culture of spiritual realization, He'll never fall down. That's sincerity. Because we are weak and the material energy is very strong. So, to adopt spiritual life is more or less declare war against the material energy. The material, the illusory energy, she is trying to curb this conditioned soul as far as possible. Now, when the conditioned soul tries to get out of her classes by spiritual advancement of knowledge, or she becomes small, stringent, yes, she wants to test how much this person is sincere. So there will be so many allurements offered by the material energy. Now, there is a story, there are many stories. One of them I am citing is very interesting. Vishwamitra Muni, he was a great king, Kshatriya. But his priest, Vasishtha Muni, he had great spiritual power. So he renounced his kingdom. He wanted to advance. He was kingly, royal order, but still he wanted to advance in the spiritual order. So he adopted yoga process, meditation. That time it was possible for adopting this process, yoga process. So he was meditating in such a way that the Indra, who was the king of heaven, he thought that this man is trying to occupy my post. As there is competition, this is also, heaven means that is also material world. So this competition, no businessman wants than another businessman go ahead. He wants to cut down competition of price, quality. Similarly, that Indra, he thought that this man is so strongly meditating. It may be that I may be deposed and he comes to my seat. Then he arranged one of his society girls, Menaka, to go there and allure this Muni. So when Menaka approached that rishi, Vishvamitra rishi. She was meditating and simply by the sound of her bangles, she could understand that there is some omen. And as soon as he saw that heavenly celestial beauty, he was captivated. There was a result that a Shakuntala Paras. Some of you may know there is a book made by Kalidas, Shakuntala. This Shakuntala is supposed to be the most beautiful girl in the world. And she was born by this combination of Vishvamitra Muni and Manotara. So when this girl was born, then Vishvamitra thought, I was advancing in my spiritual culture, and again I have been entrapped. So he was going out. At the same time, his wife, Menaka, brought this girl before her. And little child is always attractive. She thought, you have got such a nice girl, such beautiful girl, and you are going away. No, you should take care. So there is a picture, very nice, that is a very famous picture, that Menaka is showing Vishvamitra Muni, the girl, and the Muni is no more shown. Yes, there is a picture. That is, then you enter. So there are chances of failure. There are chances of failure, just like a great saint, like Vishvamitra Muni. He also failed. Failed for the time being. But Krishna says that this failure is not unsuccessful. As we have sometimes the proverb that failure is the pillar of success, especially in the spiritual life, this failure is not discouraging. This failure is not discouraging. So Krishna says that even one fails in completing his spiritual course, still there is no loss on his part. Patha naiva yaha means in this world, na amutra means next world, vinasastasya vidyate. He will never vanquish vinasastasya vidyate, nahi kalyanakre. Anyone who takes this auspicious line of spiritual culture, kasti durgatim satagacchati, he will never have fall down. And why? Na prapa punna kritam lokan anusitya shastati sama suchinam simatam gehe yoga bhrasta sanjayati abhijaya. He says that this failure yogi, one who is successful, he enters into the kingdom of God. That is a different thing. But one who is a failed student, what happens to him? Na prapa punna kritam lokam. He enters into the planet where pious living entities are allowed to enter. That means he gets into the higher planet. There are many planets within the universe, and the higher planets, there are more comforts, more duration of life, persons are more pious, religious, godly. As you make progress to the higher planets, these facilities are there, 1,000 times better than this planet. So Krishna says that even if he is failure, still, he goes to such planets where pious men are elevated. Prapva punna kritan lokan and anushitta shastati samaha, and he remains there for a long duration of time. Now, in the heavenly kingdom, it is said that our 6 months is 6 months as equal to their one day. And similarly, they live there for 10,000 years. This description we get from Vedic literature. Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, you have got the duration of life of Brahma, that is the highest planet. So, Krishna says that after, even if he is a failure, he gets promotion to the higher planet. But in the higher planet, he cannot remain for all the time. Kine punna punah matalokam visanti. When your pious balance is finished, then you are again fallen in this earth. Kine punne puna matalokam visanti. Matalokam and this matalokam. This earth. Now even when he comes back here, he says, Lord Krishna says, that he gets his birth, suchinam simatangihi yoga brasta vijayate. He takes his birth in a family. Two kinds of family. One family, simatang. Simatang means very rich family. Very rich family. So, one who takes his birth in a very rich family, it should be understood that he was certainly a very pious man in his previous life. By good work, by pious work, we get, in our next life, we get facilities. Four kinds of facilities. What are they? Janma, Aishajya, Sutta, Sri. Janma, Aishajya, Sutta, Sri. Janma means to get birth in very aristocratic family, royal family, lord family, rich family, janma, acquires large extent of wealth, janma is just sutta. Sutta means becomes very learned scholar. So one who is learned scholar, it is to be understood that it is due to his past deeds. One who is rich man, it is understood that it is due to his past acts in his last life. Janma is just sutta sri. Sri means beauty. And one who is very beautiful, either male or female, it is understood that this is the result of his or her pious work in the past life. So here it is said that suchinam simatangehe yogabhrasta sanyas. Suchinam means pious family. Pious family means Brahmin. They are suchi. Suchi means always pure. Suchi means Brahmins, means culture, Brahmins. They are always pure. Their habits, their behavior, everything is pure. That is called suchina. That is their greater facility. And simata, rich family. So the yoga bhrashta, after living for many days in the higher planet, where pious people have entered, then when he again comes to this earth, he gets birth either in a Brahmin family, suchina, or in a great rich mercantile family. Suchinam simatam. Simatam is generally meant the rich mercantile family. Just like you have got in your country, Rockefeller family, Ford family, there are many. In India also, there are Birla family, Bomber family. Every country, there are rich families. So, either in a purified family, just like Brahmins, or in a rich family. So at least, those who sincerely begin spiritual life, so their next life is guaranteed human life, human form of life, for many days. So those who are rich in this world, or those who have got birth in a very pious family, Brahmin family. They should understand that it is God's grace that I have got my work with such so much facilities of life. Why Suchinam? In a pious family, one gets the chance of spiritual advancement. I can say practically from my own life, I was fortunate to get my birth in a very pious family. Yes. My father was very pious man, and I wanted to imitate him in my childhood. Of course, our family was not very poor, but we are not very rich men. But my father was very pious man. So he was worshipping Krishna. So I, in my childhood, I was 5 or 6 years old, I requested my father, the father, give me this deity, I shall worship. So father purchased for me little Krishna, Radha, and he gave me. And I was imitating whatever foodstuff I was getting, I was offering to Krishna and eating. In this way, I got my life developed. And there was a temple in our neighborhood. So I was seeing the Krishna deity. Oh, I was thinking many things. I still remember. I was standing for hours together. So in this way, practically, we can understand that these facilities are given by the Lord. The Lord is always prepared to give us facilities. Simply, He wants to see that we are sincere. That's all. There is a nice verse in Srimad Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam, Tattva sadhanmam charanam bhujam hari bhajan apakuta patetatu jedi tatra kuva abhadda ahut amustatin kuvarthi artho abhadatam sadharma bhajatam sadharma abhadatam sadharma. Yes, the part of this verse is that tatra sadharmam. Sadharma means every particular person has got his prescribed duty of life. Every particular person. Whatever he may be, in whatever country or whatever society, everyone has got his some designated duty that you are to do this. Now, here it is said that if he gives us his duty, prescribed duty, and by sentiment, by association, or by craziness or anyway, he takes surrender unto Krishna. People may say, oh, these people are crazy. All right, even crazy. Somewhere or other, if he takes shelter unto Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God. When I say Krishna, that means God. Then what happens? Tattva sadhanmam charanamrujam hare, by sentiment or by any reason. There may be many reasons. If one takes shelter of Krishna, the Supreme Lord. But bhajan, while he was worshipping or persecuting his spiritual rules and regulations, apakya, he does not become mature, but somehow or other falls down. Satya sadhanam charanamujam hare bhajan. Bhajan means worshipping. Apakya, immature, and falls down. The Narad says in this Bhagavad, tatra kuva and abhadra avuda mustaking. So what is there inauspicious for him there? Suppose he has fallen down. There is no inauspiciousness. But a person who does not approach God, but regularly makes his duties perfectly, what does he get? What does he get? That means he does not get any benefit of his life. But a person, even if he falls down, because he has taken shelter of the Supreme Lord, oh, he is better. So, these things are sanctioned by Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita and all Vedic literature. There is no harm if one is not able to fulfill his mission properly. Happiness is still. Why? Why he is not in lost? The next closest. Again, Lord says that either in a Brahmin family, very pious family, or in a rich family, athava, or yoginam eva kule bhavati bhimata. Yogina. In a family where persons are practiced through the yoga system. Yogina, bhimata. Yoginam means either devotee or meditator or great philosopher in their family. Yoginam eva kule bhavati bhimata. Bhimata means very intelligent. These transcendentalists, either philosophers or meditators, are great devotees of the Lord. They are considered the highest top of the human society. Bhimata. Etat bhi dullabataram loke janma jad idrisham. Now, out of the three, either he gets his birth in a Brahmin family, or in a rich family, or in a family where people are, members are highly advanced in the yoga. So Krishna says, the third one is to be considered more fortunate. Third one, who has got his birth in the family of a yogi. Because one who has got his birth in a rich family, he may be misled. And naturally, it so happens. When a man gets rich at silver spoon in mouth, he thinks, oh, I have got so much money, my paternal property. Let me enjoy it. Oh, see, sometimes he becomes a drunkard, a prostitute hunter, and the rogue he becomes. Similarly, in a Brahmin family also, just like we have seen in India, there are many persons who are born in a big, very fast family. But because he has taken his birth in a fast family, he thinks I am Brahmin. Oh, what I have to do? I am a very fast family. The mistake in that way. So this is digress. So in the pious family or in the rich family, there is chance of degradation. But one who takes his birth in a family of yogi, devotee, he has got better chance for cultivating the same spiritual culture from which in his past life he has fallen. Therefore Krishna says, etad hi dullabatam. This is very rare that a man gets his birth, a parent, a yogi. This is very rare. But it is, he recommends, he eulogizes this sort of family. Then, what is the facility of this family? Now, Lord says, tatratam buddhisam yogam labhate purvadrihikam. In his previous birth, in his previous body, whatever he cultured, now he begins to remember. He begins to remember. I may tell you that those who have taken this society, Krishna consciousness, very seriously, they are not ordinary persons. They must have had such culture in their previous life. Now they are again trying to revive that. It is said, according to Bhagavad Gita, tattvatam buddhi sangyogam labhate purvadehikam. Because that asset is there. Suppose I make my bank balance. 10,000 million or something big, very big, big bank. Now as soon as my body is finished, the bank balance is also finished. Because the bank balance is not going with me. That remains in the bank to be enjoyed by somebody else. But the spiritual culture, suppose if you have not 10,000 or even 10% you have done, that goes with you. So there is no loss. Then again you begin from 11%. From the 11th point you begin. So we should consider that when you get such chance of spiritual cultivation, maybe 10%, 5%, or 50%, we should know that now we should finish the balance percentage of cultivation. We must finish this life. I shall not take chance of another birth. That should be our determination. Povadehikam. When I have come to this point, it must be understood that I had some effect in my previous life. So Krishna is giving me chance to make further progress. Now, in my past life, I could not finish this job somewhere other, but that doesn't matter. Now this life, I shall not allow to miss this opportunity. That should be our determination. As soon as we begin some spiritual culture, tatratam buddhisamyogam labhate purvadehikam. Purvadehikam means according to the past life. He begins. He tries. Gentlemen, boys who come here, there is an urge from within that you want. This urge is due to your past 3 years spiritual culture. This should be understood if we believe Bhagavad Gita. So we should not make any more fall down. We should finish this business in this life. So that, according to Bhagavad Gita, as it is said, tattādehaṁ punarjanmanaiti māmīti chodhi. Then after leaving this body, then he does not take birth again in this material world, where janma mrityujara vyadhi, repeated birth and death, diseases are there, but he comes back to me. Samāsitaṁ de padapallavam plavam mahatpadaṁ punnajaso murāre. Mahatpadaṁ punnajaso murāre. Murāre means Krishna. One who takes shelter under the lotus feet of Krishna, then for him this place, which is padaṁ padaṁ jad vipadāṁ nati, a place where in every state there is danger. This material world is supposed that every state there is danger. Let's see what we are doing. In all sense, culturing some spiritual process, and there are so many complaints. You see. We are not feeling, we are not, making propaganda for some political purpose or some nothing, innocent thing you are doing. But it's still, somebody comes forward and puts some dangerous things. So this is such a place. Lord Jesus Christ, his only fault was that he was preaching God's message. He was crucified. So these things, this place is like that. Even if you are innocent, it still you will be put into danger. Therefore this place should be avoided. Padang padang jada vipadam. Every state there is danger. So one who takes the spiritual culture, for them this place is unfit. Unfit. My Guru Maharaj used to say that this place is not fit for any gentleman's living. he was to say like that. This place is unfit for any gentleman to live. So,
Tatota, Jatateta Tatum Huya, Samsito Kurunandana, Kurunandana,
oh my dear Arjuna, when he gets a chance to revive his own spiritual culture, automatically he tries for it, sincerely. Kurunandana, Jatateta Tatum Huya.
How? Buddha Bhyatena,
Tinayi. Because he had his practice in his previous life. Therefore, it appeals to him. Nothing appeals anything more. He has got a test from the previous life. It appeals to him. Just like somebody is forcing. Oh, you take it. You take it. Just like one who is sinful, he is also forced to go to the body street. You see? Similarly, what means quiet in his life and has begun the spiritual path, he is forced to cultivate and make progress. Because if God is within you, God is within you. And sarvasya chaham yadi sannivishta, he is seated in everyone's heart. Matta smriti jnana, he gives reminders. Yes. You missed this point from here. Now, come on. Begin again. Be perfect. Don't lose this chance. He's so kind. Smriti jnana, he's giving knowledge, remembrance. And one who wants to forget God, yes, he forgets. You come to this, here is your place. He gives us chance in every way.